Senators John McCain and Lindsey Graham both urging Washington to right now send 20,000 troops to Syria and Iraq, 10,000 each, to defeat ISIS and solve the Syrian refugee crisis. The United Nations so far says that more than 4.3 million people have fled Syria since the start of the civil war. About 2,300 of them have settled here in the United States. Back with me, Steve Rogers, Ambassador James Woolsey, and Tammy Bruce. Ambassador, a lot of folks are divided on this. Some say troops on the ground might or may not help. Some say we may or may not be able to get the Sunnis to help. But it feels like steady as she goes is not working.
Well, it's deja vu all over again. Senator Graham and Senator McCain urged back in 07 or so, when the war was not going well, urged the surge along with General Keane and others. The surge worked, and by the time President Obama took office, the war was going quite well. He decided to withdraw completely, and as a result, he's ended up and not to challenge Bashar Assad, even though he said that he had crossed a red line when he used chemical weapons against his own people. As a result of this kind of fiddling around approach in the Obama administration, we've started now to see something very much like the mess that existed when the surge was urged some years before.
Yeah.
How many times do we have to go through this before people realize if you're going to fight a war, you have to fight it. You don't fiddle around with it.
Yeah, fighting the war to win would be a novel thing these days. You know, of course, President Obama had his own little surge that actually worked again. So we're seeing these surges work. But again, this need to get out responsibly, I call it retreating responsibly, is at the top of his agenda. But is it too little too late to say, now let's send in ground troops?
Well, it is. Look, I mean, this is the end of 2015. We need, for any plan to work, you've got to have a commander-in-chief who cares, whose heart is into it, who is a warrior, who understands what it's going to take. If there's anything in Barack Obama, we know that's not it. So you would actually be putting at risk these 20,000 troops. The rules of engagement are non-existent, and if they exist, it is so that you don't wake up, let's say, Afghans in Afghanistan by firing on the enemy in the night, or you don't want to relieve yourself in the direction of Mecca. The rules of engagement put our troops at risk, and I agree we should be going in there, but with a commander-in-chief who is committed to that line. Clearly, Barack Obama's not. And look, you've got Lindsey Graham, who's a failed candidate for president. Same with John McCain. John McCain lost to this man, and he's going to sit there and now say what needs to happen. It's an insult and highlights the problem also
Although,
with the Republican Party.
Although, Steve, waiting 2 years, hopefully for the right new president to make this decision, that would be a long time. I mean, a lot bad things could happen between now and then with
Charles,
this current plan.
Charles, the only exit strategy for American troops is body bags, for goodness sakes. Look, what about Saudi Arabia, Jordan, and the countries that have a lot at stake here? What about these young, strong men, these refugees, who should be doing the fighting? The point is this, and we forgot one more point, all right? And I hope we don't do this, but if we go in and we beat ISIS, what do we do when we come face to face with Vladimir Putin's army? What are we going to do with Russia?
And the Iranians.
So you're saying don't do anything, just let it go.
Strategic massive bombing, and let the others take care of the ground.
Right, you've got Iranians and Russians on boots on the ground there now.
All right, guys, thank you all very much. Appreciate it.